update on my situation with future sister-in-law and the dress I'm wearing to her wedding. Original post. I don't know if I can include a dress, but Thursday was my 40th birthday. I usually don't celebrate birthdays. My husband, 40 male, just makes me dinner and give me a present. And then my mom invites me for breakfast and gives me a present from the whole family. But when I turned 20 and 30, I had a bigger party, and now do. I invited immediate family and my closest friends. The party was yesterday and it was a great day, and I'm so hungover now. I noticed that brother-in-law, husband's brother, 46 male, and his fiancée, 28 female, were a bit standoffish. But my soon-to-be sister-in-law is always standoffish with me, so nothing new. But today my husband woke up to a long text message berating us because I wore a white dress. They're getting married in 2 weeks and I should have known better. To be honest, I swear in my grandma's grave that I didn't think about any of this. Future sister-in-law thinks that I always wear inappropriate clothes that draws attention to me. So now she's demanding to see what I will be wearing at her wedding. I ask if they're asking everyone. Nope, just me. I said, then I refuse. Now they say I'm an a-hole for wearing white, and then for refusing to show the dress I'm wearing to the wedding, threatening to disinvite my husband and I. My husband is conflicted, but I don't know. I think I'd rather have my husband go alone than being treated like a child. Am I the a-hole for wearing white to my party? And am I the a-hole for refusing to show my dress for the wedding? Now for the top comments before reading the update. Not the a-hole. Your future sister-in-law is crazy. Not the a-hole. Careful with a black dress. Your future sister-in-law has a funeral sometime this year and is planning to wear black. Tell sister-in-law you are planning to tie-dye your birthday dress to wear to her wedding. Not the a-hole. She's freaking deluded. Seriously, I would ask why she's making your birthday about her. It has absolutely nothing to do with her wedding. I will say if you skip the wedding, it would only escalate the situation. She's clearly deranged. If she chooses to uninvite you, however, problem solved. This is it. Your day, wear whatever you want. On her wedding day, sure, don't wear white. But on my birthday, you're going to tell me what is appropriate? Who does she think she is? This is obviously a jealous thing, seems like. Maybe the brother made a comment or looked at her in a way that made fiancé uncomfortable? Not OP's problem. Personally, I wouldn't attend a wedding. Apparently, getting married in 2 weeks means she owns the color white for as long as she wants. Ridiculous. Not the a-hole. Not the a-hole. Your dress choice for either event is perfect. For your husband's sake, because this is his brother and his family and his drama and he has to deal with the fallout, I would send a picture of the wedding outfit. Just because I love my husband and want him to have an easier time with life, and I can easily make that happen. I would now send a model pic. That will set her off. I would have you wearing the dress. Either first thing in the morning or just got off work. Bedraggled. No makeup. No foundation garments. Hair a mess. Maybe some fluffy socks on. Post in a bathroom or in a mirror at a bad angle with your hand with a phone in the way. Just make it look like a sack. Get clear approval. Then when you show up in the approved dress looking like $1 million, can't nobody say anything. And if they do, you've got the text message receipts to show she approved it. Now for the update. Okay, so I was very surprised about the amount of support I got. Thank you, because I was starting to doubt myself. I just want to make it clear that the only one I care about right now is my husband and his feelings, because somehow I felt that he is in the middle of the crossfire right now. So I talked to him and apologized for my pettiness. He was surprised and said that I had nothing to apologize for. Requesting to only approve of my dress out of the 270 guests? It's insulting and disrespectful. You don't do that to family. So I told him that maybe I shouldn't go to the wedding after all. Sister-in-law never liked me anyway, and I'm sure I'm only invited because she can't not to. She'd be happy if I didn't attend, and the whole thing felt like she was finding an excuse to disinvite me. My husband then can go and be there for his brother. Everybody wins. My husband called my brother-in-law to tell him that I couldn't come, and he will be attending by himself. Brother-in-law said, okay, cool. Problem solved, right? No, no. Future sister-in-law texted me saying that I needed to show her the dress, and refusing to show her means that she is right, and I have chosen something inappropriate and trashy. I texted back, oh, I thought you've spoken to your fiancé. I won't be attending. She texted an hour later, yes, I have spoken to my fiancé. If you remember from yesterday, none of you are welcome if you don't show me the dress. So if you still refuse, neither you nor husband can attend. I talked to my husband now, and he literally had no words. He said to stop texting future sister-in-law and that he will fix this. So I'm staying the heck out of this. Your sister-in-law is unreasonable, burning with envy, and the extent she took is just pathetic. Both the white birthday dress, which you had every right to wear to your own birthday, and your wedding reception dress are gorgeous. But I believe your dresses are not the issue here, but rather her inferiority complex. Good luck to your brother-in-law. And if he's as pathetic as his soon-to-be wife, good luck to all of you dealing with him. My thoughts exactly. Just cut them dead to avoid a lifetime of this pedantic nonsense. You should send her a picture of your dress worn by your husband. She is crazy. But also, brother-in-law should date women his age. Lol, brother-in-law is another gem. He cheated on his ex because she had several miscarriages. And when he got caught, he said it was because he was depressed for not having a family. They divorced. This was 3 years ago. Now his ex is pregnant with her new man, who is actually future sister-in-law's ex-boyfriend. And brother-in-law is devastated she moved on faster than him. So I think this whole marriage is to one-up his ex, to be honest, because she's not married yet. Of course, these are all speculation and gossip. I thought maybe you would appreciate some background story slash gossip. Cheating on someone suffering multiple miscarriages? This a-hole is the devil. Hopefully an STI that he gave her didn't cause the miscarriages. Just skip the wedding. Tell them both you'll make it to the next one. Dogs don't change their spots. I've actually heard that leopards can't change their shorts. A snake can shed its skin, but it doesn't make it any less of a snake. I still say show up to the wedding in your birthday dress. Still the only wedding I would suggest this level of pettiness. Well, my other sister-in-law, my husband's sister, heard this whole thing about us being disinvited and said if we didn't attend, she's going to ask all the cousins to wear revealing dresses. She sounded like she mean it. While it's hilarious, I really hope it doesn't escalate into this type of petty. To be honest, it sounds like the pettiness needs to be matched. I think it would be a good thing for the entire family to do everything in their power to bother her. What's the worst that could happen? She's already lost every single one of her marbles, so there's no worry she'll lose them now. Some people never had boundaries enforced around them before. And sister-in-law is clearly too entitled to comprehend basic English y'all been speaking. Think of it as doing a service for the public, because we want to get this a-hole the heck out of your family, but we gotta make sure she ain't gonna go terrorize some other suckers. People need to learn. She obviously wasn't taught as a child, and she's old enough now to catch some hands. Not saying any of y'all should throw them, but someone is going to eventually, be it someone from your family eventually getting fed up or her next victims. Next story. Am I the a-hole for refusing to be the godparent for my ex's baby? I, 32 female, and my ex, 27 male, are fairly successful business partners. We were friends at first, slowly we got together and were together for 3 years. I made it clear that I am asexual. I have no desire for intimate. The whole act ranges from disgusting to indifference for me. I had a very traumatic experience in the past, which resulted in my daughter, 8 female, whom I love very much. My ex understood and said he doesn't have high libido either and wants to be with me. I was madly in love and thought finally met my match. But 3 months ago, it all came crashing down. When I found out he has been cheating on me for months and his affair partner is pregnant, I was devastated to say the least. But I have decided to be celibate for the rest of my life to save myself from heartbreak. I moved away from my ex to another state as we are expanding our business. I plan to move with my daughter permanently once it's set up. My ex's family love me and I love them too. We share a good relationship despite my ex. His grandparents invited me to celebrate their anniversary over brunch. I love them, and we three share inside jokes. Ex and his now pregnant girlfriend were present. I managed to avoid them for most part. But ex's girlfriend got up, announced her pregnancy, and looked at me straight in the eye and said, "We want you to be our munchkin's godparent. Once he comes?" I was awkward, anxious, and straight up mad. I snort laughed to keep my appearance and said, "Oh, you don't want that. I am moving away. The baby needs someone who can be around." The party went silent and the mood definitely changed. I left in the next 40 minutes. My ex has been blowing up my phone and calling me selfish, that I didn't consider the grandparents' feelings and ruin their day. They are all very upset over how the party turned out, and his girlfriend is embarrassed and has been crying. I asked him why did he put me in that situation, and he said grandparents were very upset I wasn't going to be part of the family anymore. So girlfriend thought making me godparent would somehow make them happy? I've stopped responding, but I do feel guilty for ruining their party. Maybe I should have dealt with it in private. I love them, and I don't want this to be our last moment. Now for the comments. Lol, they thought they could put you on the spot into accepting and legitimizing their affair in the eyes of the family, and they are mad you didn't play along. Ignore them. They were classless, tacky a-holes all the way. I would have responded, you are out of your damn mind to ask me that. Were you raised by baboons? Took the words right out of my mouth. Your ex and his mistress were selfish enough to put you on the spot for their benefit, and now have the gall to say you're being selfish. They are the ones who upset his grandparents, not you. Also, sounds like his grandparents aren't thrilled about having a home wrecker in the family. Not the a-hole. The audacity asking you to be godparent to their unborn baby when your ex cheated on you with her. So wild that people do this. The disrespect. Right? I just saw on another post someone use the phrase, the lion, the witch, and the audacity of this bitch. And that is definitely running through my head with his story too. Not the a-hole. If ex is going to gaslight you and guilt trip you even before the baby is born, maybe it's best to split up the business? The business in another state is yours and the business in this state is his? After you take your share, of course, and have a lawyer draw an airtight contract. Your ex is a cheater. One who cheats in marriage will cheat in business. You are friends. You're just civil acquaintances now. What's next? They'd ask you to be maid of honor at their wedding? The business was initially funded by his grandparents and my parents. My brother will be stepping in my place, and I will be setting up the out-of-state one. I will tell my brother to keep an eye on him. Haha, no wonder his grandparents are giving him grief. You are the one couple to join the families in business forever, and you ruined that. Last story. Am I the a-hole for letting my friend struggle with her newborn baby? I, female 31, have a friend 32. Let's call her Laura. We've been friends since elementary school, but our relationship had a few rough patches. We're close, but she can be a little self-centered and callous. I know it's rooted in childhood trauma, and it's not intentional. She suffers the most from constantly driving people away, but sometimes it's still hard to stay by her side. Laura had a one-night stand and got pregnant. I told her it would be irresponsible to be a single mom when she can barely support herself, but she's decided to keep it anyway. So now she has a 2-month-old daughter, Mia. She had to quit her job halfway through the pregnancy because it was harder than expected and obviously can't go back in the near future. She's also depleted her savings, and now her only income is childcare benefit and monthly allowance from her parents until she can get a job, but it's not enough to cover her expenses. Last week, she came up with the idea that they could move into my guest room. She thinks it'd be perfect because I own the apartment, so there's no rent. We can split bills and groceries. I can watch the baby when Laura's tired, and she can help out with chores while I'm working. I said no and couldn't even explain why, because she immediately started screaming about how I'm selfish, heartless a-hole. How can I be so cruel and cold and that I don't understand what she's going through? I try to tell her to move back home because I know Laura's mom already offered it, but she called me an a-hole again because as a mother, she can't live with her parents. Even though she can be a bit entitled, it's never been this bad, so her behavior came as a surprise. I gave her a few days to calm down, then I called to explain that while I love them both, I can't take them in. I've already helped Laura buy newborn essentials, and I told her I can help cleaning or cooking so she can have some rest, but I can't do anything more. I've recently been diagnosed with panic disorder. I'm at the end of my rope, and I'm clearly not in a mental or emotional state to basically adopt a family. She started crying and said that she's disappointed in me because I have no idea what it means to be a mother, and I don't even try to understand her situation. Then she told me she's not sure anymore if they even need me in their life. I feel guilty and terrible for not being able to do more for them, especially for Mia, who doesn't deserve to grow up like this. And I know Laura needs help, because being a single mother is terrifying. But I can't do more. I can't do more. She says her real friend wouldn't put herself first. But if I don't put myself first now, I'm not sure I'll ever be able to recover from this disorder. But maybe she's right, and I'm just being a selfish a-hole now. Am I? Not the a-hole. Laura has a consequence, and now wants to freeload off of you? You might be dodging a bullet if she cuts you off. Yep. That was a preview of her true behavior. Be thankful you saw that before you agreed to let her move in. You can be a supportive friend without letting her move in and walk all over you. If that's not good enough for her, then it's her loss, not yours, not the a-hole. They never considered or offered or discussed letting her move in. This was totally the friend's scheme. I think so too. She straight up invited herself to live in Opie's apartment, rent-free I might add, because Sis made sure to point out that since Opie owned a unit, there was no rent, which is hilarious. And then Volan told Opie to babysit for free probably every single evening after work. Absolutely not. Opie is not obliged to play full house with his friend. She acts just a little entitled? No, how about entitled in a major way? She's the only one who got pregnant and quit her job because it was too hard. She has an expectation of everyone taking care of her in the manner she sees fit. Sorry, that is not how the world works. She should be able to find daycare and start working. Yes, being a parent, especially a single parent, can be hard. This is what she chose. It's no reflection on you for drawing boundaries and not taking her in and supporting her. It's rather presumptuous of her to assume that this would be okay. I don't care if she has an abuse history in the past. She's making these decisions and nobody else. You are not the a-hole here and stick to your boundaries. She needs to figure this out and it's not on you to support her or her newborn daughter. She says a real friend wouldn't put herself first. Well then, she isn't a real friend because all she's doing is putting herself first, not the a-hole. A real mother would put herself first. Her mother already offered her help and a place to live, and she won't move back in because… reasons? And my guess is those reasons are entirely ego-related, or her mother will expect her to contribute to her own upkeep. Probably because she'll have to pay a bit of rent and help around the house, and contribute to the group like a responsible adult.